Hi, I'm Dr. Andrea Sundholm. We are going to show you how to scrub into surgery. So we have a couple of options here. We have a traditional hand scrub with Betadine, and then we also have a alcohol-based hand solution as well. So for the first scrub of the day, traditionally people have talked about using the hand sponge or scrub. Here, basically what you can do is just start by washing your hands, and then we tend to go straight for the alcohol-based solution. This is less abrasive to your skin, has been shown to be appropriate as well. So regardless, the first thing that you're going to do is just wash your hands with a normal hand soap and then utilize the fingernail cleaners to get under each of your fingernails. You should have pretty short nails when doing surgery. The recommendation is 2 millimeters or less. So if they're too long, go ahead and cut them before you start surgery. But then use your fingernail cleaner to get under each fingernail, and then basically just wash your hands after that. And then when you're finished with that, you can either start with your surgical scrubber brush, and then again we only have iodine here or Betadine, but you can, there's chlorhexidine ones as well, but I'm going to use the alcohol based hand solution. So typically you just want to get your hands and every single surface of your finger wet with the solution down your forearms, and so you just individually put pumps into your hand, get your fingers and your cuticles, and then another pump in the other hand, same thing for the other hand,
getting every side of each finger, the palms of your hands, the back sides of your hands, go down over your wrists. Same thing. And then it's a similar area that you're trying to cover as what you would with the more traditional scrub and sponge combination. But the important part with this, again, is just letting it dry on your hands. I think we have the temptation to kind of wave our hands around to get it to go faster, but that kind of defeats the purpose. So the whole process of drying should take about a minute and a half. So during that time, I'm just kind of rubbing my hands around. Maybe I'm making my way into the operating room, but waiting until all of this is dried before putting on your gown and gloves.